Are you considering having an aesthetic procedure performed?
Confused by all the information out there?
Welcome to It's a Young Thing,
where Nurse Paula Young arms you with the knowledge on all things cosmetic and aesthetic.
And now, Nurse Paula Young.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to It's a Young Thing. I'm Nurse Paula Young. Thank you so much for joining us again this week. And you know, a lot of procedures that we do in the medical spa environment do not have to do really with anything that involves beauty or looking better per se. And we've already touched upon a couple of topics that like the O shot and the P shot and Thermiva, things that can really help someone just feel a lot better about themselves and just have more control of their body and just feel more comfortable in their own skin. And you know, one of the things that we do treat in a medical spa and plastic surgery environment is severe underarm sweating. And there's actual medical terminology for this, and it's called hyperhidrosis. Hyper meaning excess, hydrosis meaning, you know, sweating or water. So this, you know, we sweat for a reason. We sweat to cool our body, and you know, it's just important to be able to regulate temperature, especially in the summertime when you're running or working out or you're outside. But people who have hyperhidrosis, they just sweat when they're just sitting still sometimes. And usually it's the hands or the feet or the head. But in our industry, we primarily focus on underarm sweating. And it can be so bad for these people that they can soak completely through their clothes. In some cases, it can even cause skin infections. Sometimes what they'll do is they'll put some absorbent pads inside the underarms of their jackets or shirts to stop the sweating and keep it from soaking through their fabric. And they even avoid certain blends of fabrics that can help make them sweat more or show the sweat more. So, you know, they take changes of clothes with them sometimes, or towels or powders, and they're something that they're constantly doctoring up all day long to hide. So hyperhidrosis, it can be evident even as a child or in adolescence when puberty and hormones start to hit. And it can also be a side effect from maybe some medications, some prescription medications or some food supplements, or even a medical condition like menopause or diabetes or hyperthyroidism, just to name a few. So really, it should be ruled out first by your primary care physician. You really should go see your primary care doc to see if there's something else underlying going on. It can be a real cause of embarrassment for people, anxiety and depression. And you know what? The good thing is it's treatable. And if it's determined to be, say, related to menopause, then you would treat menopause first. So if it's determined to be, you know, a result, direct result of a condition or a medication, then you treat that first, and then it should subside or at least, you know, reduce in intensity. So a common mistake that people make a lot of times is they're using a deodorant, and they really should be using an antiperspirant. And you should apply this to dry skin even before going to bed at night. There are prescription antiperspirants that you can get from a dermatologist, and that can help as well. But we're talking about people that they've tried this and it's just not helping at all. Now, in the old days, surgery was the only option, and it's not done much today because of all the new advancements that there are out there in aesthetic medicine. So there's several treatments available. So first of all, let's talk about Botox. We talked about Botox in a previous podcast, Tell Me About My Botox. And this is what the starlets use on the red carpets so they don't sweat through the designer gowns that they're wearing. Botox was the miracle after only the surgical option was available. And what it does is it turns the sweat glands off for about 6 to 8 months, which is longer than what we use it for facial muscles, because that usually lasts like 4 or 5 months. 6 to 8 months is a lot longer because you're not going into muscles per se, you're going into the sweat glands. And it's an easy treatment, 5 minutes per arm. Some places use the cornstarch method. And what that is they'll sprinkle cornstarch underneath your armpit. And then as you sweat, the cornstarch turns black. And that lets you know where to inject. Typically, what we do in our office, we use no pre-medication. You really don't need it. It's just a small Botox insulin type syringes. And what we do is we mark out approximately 20 injection points about 1 centimeter apart in the area where you grow hair in your armpit. Typically, I'd say it's an average average of 50 units of Botox on each side. There's no bruising and there's no downtime. It's more than 90% effective. It has an FDA indication for this use. And sometimes it's covered by insurance, but you know, those insurance companies, sometimes they can make it quite cumbersome to get reimbursement on it. And it's also available through Allergan, the Brilliant Distinctions program. You can actually earn reward points on whatever Botox you buy or any Allergan products you buy. You earn these reward points and you end up getting, you know, cash dollars back. So usually what you'll do is you'll get treatments back when you start seeing the, you know, slowly you're starting to sweat more than usual. You're starting to get more damp. That's usually your indication that it's time to get new injections. Okay, so now another treatment that's non-invasive is called MiraDry. Now, this is an actual device that uses electromagnetic energy, kind of like microwaves, to destroy the underarm sweat glands. A topical anesthetic is applied. And the device sucks the skin up into the head of the device. It uses like mild suction and it pulls it up into the handpiece and then it heats it and then it cools the skin. Each treatment takes about an hour with little to no downtime. Now, this is non-invasive. It kills the sweat glands, but one or more treatments are necessary. And this works about 90% of the time. Now, let's talk about one more treatment. Now, this is a permanent treatment. And it's Precision TX. Remember, we talked about Smart Lipo. If you go back to our Smart Lipo podcast, Precision TX is a wavelength of light on the Smart Lipo triplex system. And it's a minimally invasive procedure. And the laser during the Precision TX is a side-firing laser. So the laser shoots out the side of the fiber that goes underneath the skin, and it destroys the sweat glands. This is the most advanced approach for treating hyperhidrosis. There's little to no downtime. You usually can return to the work the next day or after. And the little puncture sites are small and they're well hidden. But, you know, you are a little sore underneath your armpits for a couple days. And we use Temesin anesthesia, which is a local anesthetic underneath the skin, to make the procedure a little bit more comfortable. Usually one treatment is all that's needed, but you know, there's a lot of mixed results out there. It's very operator dependent, and we think it pretty much needs more studies to determine, you know, how efficacious it really is for patients. So that's it for hyperhidrosis. You know, there really are a lot of new non-invasive or minimally invasive ways to alleviate the severe underarm sweating. And, you know, really get out there, look at it. There's even national websites for hyperhidrosis that you can get a lot of information on. And there's a lot of agencies out there that are there to help you and get you more information. I just wanted to briefly touch upon the three types of treatments that you can currently see available in medical spas and plastic surgery offices and dermatology offices. So make sure, you know, you check out your provider of choice and see what they have to offer. That's everything I have on hyperhidrosis for this week. Thank you so much for joining us. Make sure you subscribe to my podcast and share. We're on iHeartRadio, iTunes, SoundCloud, and we're also on our website at youngmedicalspa.com. Thank you so much. We'll talk to you next time.
You've been listening to It's a Young Thing with Nurse Paula Young. If we didn't discuss a topic you're interested in today, be sure to subscribe to our podcast on iTunes so when we do, you don't miss it. The cosmetic aesthetic world can be confusing. We're here to arm you with quality, truthful information from our many years of experience. For even more info, youngmedicalspa.com.
This has been a Steve Mittman social media creation. Steve Mittman, socialmedia.com.
The creators, producers, participants, and distributors of this podcast disclaim any liability in connection with the material expressed herein. This information should not be substituted for individual medical counseling. Information on this podcast is not intended to diagnose or prescribe treatment for any condition. It is intended for educational purposes only, based on the research and experience of Young Medical Spa. Discussion of specific treatments is done only in an office visit directly with the patient. Contact our office to schedule.